Okay guys, I've been doing a lot of videos recently for World of Warcraft, and I've been using WeakAuras a lot. Now, WeakAuras is something that looks complex, but it's incredibly easy to use, and I'm just going to show you a very basic way to create very simple animations that will pop up next to your character whenever a proc comes off. So this is a WeakAura basically tutorial on how to make a proc-based WeakAura. So the first thing you want to do is open WeakAuras. Well, the first thing you want to do is download WeakAuras, link in the description. Second thing you want to do is open WeakAuras in your game. Now you're going to make sure you're hovering over the tab new, all right? You have to click new. At that point, you want to look on this right-hand side and you ask yourself, what do I want to show up next to my character? Do I want it to be a pretty little texture? Okay, is that what I want? Or perhaps you just want the icon to pop up. Maybe you want some kind of text. Maybe you want some kind of random weird 3D model. I think most people tend to just go with the first one or the icon. Okay, so progress texture will just bring you up some kind of texture whenever the proc goes off that lets you know, hey, time to use that ability, and then it slowly goes away with the duration of the proc. So let's go ahead and just try a basic progress texture. So we had new clicked, and we click progress texture. Now, don't forget to name it. If you don't name it, you'll never remember where it is. It'll get really annoying later on when you have a lot of these. So this actually came up in a very opportune time for me because I'm playing my Smite build, and yeah, I needed to make a brand new WeakAuras for the proc of Smite. So what I do is I go to the talent itself. Now this one is called Surge of Light. Now, sometimes the ability itself, the proc name, does not correlate with the talent that it comes from. In this case, the way that I've done it is you can either look it up or you can just wait till it does proc, hover your mouse over it up here on the top right, and whatever it actually says, that's all you have to actually put in the trigger to make your progress texture appear. So once you've clicked progress texture, you have this baseline one that pops up. If you click choose right here, you can now pick from a host of pretty good ones of varying different types, all of which tend to apply to a real life one. So this is based on Slice and Dice. This is for Rhyme, so for a Frost Death Knight, Nightfall if you're a Warlock, Sudden Doom if you're an Unholy Death Knight. So let's just say for this one specifically, I want to take, let's say Daybreak. It's pretty cool. So what you can do is you can now adjust it the way you want. So I'm going to make mine a little bit longer, but you can also adjust it horizontally, and you can adjust it like this as well if you're one of those people that just likes to drag it from the bottom right. Let it do its own thing. Put it where you want it to be. So in my case, on my gnome character, let's just say right here. So again, this is not an advanced user guide on how to use WeakAuras. It's a basic guide on how to make a very basic WeakAura that will allow you to see your stuff when you're playing your character in a way that's more dynamic and easier to do and maybe not baseline for the private server that you're playing. But I will go ahead and say that let's pretend you just want this on the other side. You can just click mirror, it flips it, and you put it right here. Okay, that's one way you can do it. Desaturate tends to desaturate it, but you can desaturate different things, right? So if I click this one, it's only desaturating the part that goes down, the progress. If I do this one, it desaturates the entire background, and you can mix and match it, right? So some people might want it white in the background because that feels empty, and then the yellow as it comes down, and that's what I'm going to do because I think it looks pretty cool. And of course, you can change the color of these things as well. As you can see with the color picker here, I could go with blue if I wanted, and now my progress is blue. Now, for the actual trigger. Ignore animations, ignore actions, ignore load. It's just going to confuse you, and you don't really need it if you're just making basic WeakAuras. Just go to trigger, okay? Click use full scan high CPU. Now you want to click aura name. For operator, is exactly, okay? This means what you're going to end up typing right here for your aura is going to have to be exactly what pops up. And if you do that, this will pop up every single time. So in my case, I'm just going to write surge of light and click okay. Now, if you can't figure this out for some reason, another very valid way to do it is just clicking spell ID. You have to look up by just Google searching the spell ID of your specific spell. Then you need to copy it and paste it here. It should work the same way. So this is specifically for auras and procs, right? So that's all I'm going to be showing for this. Let's go ahead and show you guys an example of it now working after we've created it. There we go. So we got the crit. It was a 50% chance. And now, instant smite. And that is all you have to do to make a very basic aura based proc based WeakAuras. Had a lot of people asking me how to do it. There are a lot of sources out there, but hey, it's a quick easy video I can throw out, not much editing required. Maybe it helps some people out. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. More stuff to come. Mcdoubles out.